بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Indeed, we are all thankful that we have witnessed a new day. This is the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are inshallah going to start this program. This is the Seerah conference that is organized by the Ikna Tarbiya department. The theme of this would be the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent with a mission. So I'll introduce our next speaker. He's Imam Rafiq Mahdi. His topic would be how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam empowered the weak. Imam Rafiq Mahdi, I will just read some of your bio, if you allow me to.
Inshallah.
Mashallah, I met him when he came here during the Harvey in Houston. So, mashallah, I had the privilege of meeting the brother. He was working on the Ikna Relief team. With that said, he's the Director of Community Development for Ikna Relief. He's also the Imam of the organization. He founded in 1984, which is the Muslim Community of Knoxville. And he teaches a weekly class on the interpretation and understanding of the Quran. And he also provides, presides over weddings and funerals and counsels anyone in the community who asks for help, mashallah. Lots of roles he plays. Without further ado, I will ask him to, inshallah, proceed with his topic.
طيب جزاك الله خير يا أخي. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وبعد. All praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask his peace and blessings upon his servant and his final messenger Muhammad, upon his family and his companions and those who follow them in faith and practice until the last day. Thumma amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Nasal Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tawfiq wa afiyah. Jazakum Allah khairan for all of those whom they have joined for this auspicious conference to, mashaAllah, to learn about the life of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to just reaffirm what we are in this life for and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us by making us ummatis of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. MashaAllah, tabarakallah, the brothers and sisters have asked me to talk about how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam empowered the weak. And I think that we have to first then, of course, come to an understanding of what, who do we mean when we talk about the weak? Because as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in his book, بَعْدَ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسَ أَنْتُمْ فُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ هُوَ غَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدِ. That, oh mankind, you are indeed fuqara, you are weak, you are impoverished in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is indeed worthy of praise, independent of any aspect or need from any part of his creation. So this technical term or the meaning of weakness or da'if, that it is something that, of course, it relates to every human being. And in khulqa al-insana da'ifa, that the human being has been created in a state where we are perpetually weak, that we depend upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, that indeed every day, a minimum of 17 times a day, the Muslim and the believer is the one whom they recognize and they reaffirm that you alone, O Allah, we worship, and you alone we beseech for help, knowing that we need the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that we do. In the context of our discussion today, of course, the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, he was indeed sent with a message. He was chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be yani khatim al-nubuwah, the seal of the prophethood. And he was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khafatan lin-nas, and he is sufficient for all of mankind. Even though, of course, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he did not, you know, leave the Arabian Peninsula once the Risala came to him. And even though he did not live to see the expanse of the Muslim state outside of Jaziratul Arab, but subhanAllah, that message that Allah blessed him with and chose him for, that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he is the one that is bringing this message to all mankind. And so we look at the example of the life of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and when we think about his relationship with those whom they were marginalized in the society, that those whom perhaps they did not have the political positions, or they did not have the positions of sovereignty and responsibility in the society, those whom they were perhaps looked down upon by people, or they were discriminated against, or they were shown any prejudice and they were oppressed, that when we think of this as the meaning of what we want to discuss today, as mashallah, how the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam empowered yani the weak, then we have to think about how the weak are understood. That weakness in the sense of how we have related to them as human beings. Weakness in the sense of that we have not truly found our own worth and our own value and the richness of a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, yani he is the one that he has made that connection, he has made that bridge, because he used to treat all of the people and the same. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recognized that those people whom they were marginalized in the society, those people whom they were looked down upon, or those people whom they did not necessarily have the financial wherewithal to be respected, they did not have the, you know, political status and position, or you know, the station in the society, in the hierarchy of the society, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he treated them in such a way that they felt that they had self-worth, they felt that they were equal human beings. And this is something that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did before the Risala, and of course it was only enhanced by the revelation of the Quran and the understanding and the practice and the evolution of the Deen of Al-Islam throughout those 23 years that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received revelation before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him back. So if we look at the time of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam in Mecca, and for those 13 years during the Risala in the Meccan period, and we know that many of those early converts to Islam, that they were indeed from those that we might categorize them as weak. We might categorize them as without having much standing or significance in the society. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yani he embraced them, and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that he dealt with them in a way that made them feel the self-worth that comes with a true understanding and relationship with yani the Creator. And the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Jum'ah, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم هو الذي بعث في أميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. الآية. So these are just four of the ways that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he empowered the weak. First of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in this ayah that he has chosen the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and sent him amongst al-Umiyyin. And usually we see this term translated as illiterate or unlettered, but we want to understand it, I think, with the proper understanding that the people, or the majority of the people in Mecca and in the Arabian Peninsula, the Arabs at that time, they were not a people whom they had a formal system of education. And they did not know how to read and write. So when we think of Ummiyin, and we think of those whom they have had no formal education, it doesn't mean that they are wa'yadzubillah backward. It doesn't mean that they can't understand. It doesn't mean that they are illiterate, as it is sometimes translated. But it means that they were living their life on the fitrah and in accordance with the environment that they were experiencing, that they were born into and raised up in. And the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam was one of them. And as we know, that he did not read and he did not write. But subhanAllah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be the ways and means of those people to gain the connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And indeed, when someone has not been, exposed to some of the aspects of society that build them up to the point where they become arrogant, or they become, in a way that they feel that they are, more important than other people, or they have more value than other people, that when you bring the message to them that it is in contrast to what they have been living and their experience and understood, then they are averse to that message. As we find that most of the people in the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when they were called upon to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, when the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told them that they must eschew shirk in all of its manifestations and all of its understandings, and they should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, then they felt that, who is this person who is telling us this? Yes, we know him. Yes, we know that he has a reputation in the society, a Sadiq al-Amin. But now he is coming to us, telling us, alayhi salatu wasalam, that we have to leave all of our culture. We have to leave all of our background. We have to leave the deen, the way of life that we learned from our fathers and our grandfathers. And he has no standing to do that. So the people whom they felt that they have position in the society, that they have, lived to gain a certain level and importance, that to tell them that you have to now recognize that none of this is important, that truly what is important is the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this is difficult for some of the people to accept. But those whom perhaps they are not getting the benefit of the society in the worldly life, that they are not looked upon as being of those whom they have position or importance or authority, that they are being taken advantage of because of their lineage, because of their race, because of their lack of financial resources, that when they hear a message that tells them that true worth, true self-respect, true value comes in you recognizing and understanding La ilaha illallah, that there is no God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, then subhanAllah, this is something that does indeed empower the people. So how did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam accomplish that? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him and chose him and guided him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he gave the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam four responsibilities that we learn about in this ayah from Surah Al-Jumu'ah. And that, and yatlu alayhim ayatihi, that he is the one that recites to them the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the revelation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the final and permanent miracle for the benefit of the guidance of mankind. That if a person's heart is not full of pride, not full of arrogance, if a person's heart is not full of the love of the embellishments of the life of this world, then when they are exposed to those signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the words of Allah, then by the grace and mercy of Allah, it is easier for them to open their hearts and accept that. And we all know as Muslims, mashallah, tabarakallah, that this is the most empowering thing. And our previous speakers, and they spoke about ilm. They spoke about the importance of ilm. And indeed, the most beneficial, the most valuable ilm is the ilm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in the book of Allah. So think about the people whom, subhanAllah, in the time of the Messenger, alayhi salatu salam, ummiyin, unlettered people, that they are exposed to this knowledge, and they don't have to, they don't have to learn to read and write in order to benefit from it. And yatlu alayhim ayatihi, that they are learning it directly from the tongue and the lips of the Messenger, alayhi salatu salam. And they are taking this in, and they are learning, as the second responsibility that Allah mentions, wa yuzakkihim, that they are learning the ways and means of purification. Because inna Allah tayyib la yaqbul ila tayyib, that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pure, He only accepts that which is pure. So their hearts are being purified for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the ayat, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet ﷺ is teaching them the ways and means to connect with Rabbul Alameen, with the Lord of the worlds, to connect with the one who is Al-Alim Al-Hakim, the one who is infinite in knowledge and infinite in wisdom, the one who is Samil Alim, the one who hears and knows everything. And of course, when an individual makes that connection, then indeed, and that person becomes empowered. They become empowered through their acceptance of this kalima, la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. They become empowered through recognizing that they have a ways and means to benefit from a relationship with the one who has the power and the authority over all things. And they have empowerment by recognizing that the systems that human beings have put into place, which marginalize communities, which discriminate against communities, which hold back and repress communities based upon nothing but ignorance and arrogance, that these things are not the reality, that these things are not the purpose that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this creation for, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created our father Adam alayhi salam, and called upon and ordered, that is, the malaika to prostrate to Adam alayhi salam. So through these things, the Messenger alayhi salatu salam empowered the weak. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa yu'allimuhum al-kitab wal-hikmah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the Prophet alayhi salatu salam, that he teaches them the book. And our ulama, hafidhum rahimahullah, they mentioned that yu'allimuhum al-kitab, and he teaches them the meaning of the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this ayah, there is a differentiation made between tilawa and ta'lim. Yatlu alayhim ayati, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, recites to them the words of the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of the book. But then he teaches them the meaning of those words, that what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to understand? Well, hikmah, and how do we put that into practice in our lives? And this is something that cannot be bought. This is something that cannot be inherited. This is something that cannot, and it's subhanAllah, be held back from someone if their hearts embrace it, if Allah guides them. So this is indeed the true empowerment that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he brought for every human being. But we know that it is sunnatullah fi khalqihi, that it is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his creation, that subhanAllah, that those whom they have been defined as weak by the society, those whom they have been held back, those whom they have been dealing with hardship and difficulty, those whom that they are having the problems in this world, that they are the ones that are open to any seeing any a solution. They are the ones that want to know that how can I find fulfillment? How can I find self-worth and value if I don't have all of the trappings of what the society tells me is that is what defines those things? So Islam comes and, mashallah, tells us and shows us that the true worth of a human being is in that relationship with Allah. The true worth of a human being is the ibadah of Allah, is to establish yani, relationships based upon the love of Allah and the love of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, and to bring benefit to the society in which they live. That all of these things can be accomplished, and the weak and those whom they are marginalized in the society, they have through the whole silsilata of Nubuwwah, they are the ones whom, mashallah, that they have been more open to that message and they have been empowered by that message. And we find this yani, from the time of Nuh alayhi salam to the time of Muhammad alayhi salatu salam and until the present day. So mashallah, tabarakallah, as ummatis of Muhammad alayhi salatu salam, that we have to recognize that the responsibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, that mashallah, we have to recognize and embrace who we are. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس الآية. And we all know this ayah, that the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we are the best Ummah that has been brought forth for the benefit of mankind. That through the teaching of Islam, through the understanding and the practice of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, that we implement in our lives, we empower ourselves to be the vehicles through which we can empower those whom they are considered weak or marginalized in the society, and indeed empower anyone that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the hidayah. So alhamdulillah, mashallah, tabarakallah, ikna, Islamic Circle of North America, IGNA Relief, Helping Hand, Why Islam Gained Peace, SubhanAllah Fate, all of these branches of the good tree of IGNA working in the grassroots of the society and giving this message that this is what is allowing us to empower those who are marginalized in the society based upon what we learn of how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he did that during his life. Wa nas'alullah tawfiq wal afiya. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa astaghfiruhu innallaha laghafurur rahim. Anything I've said is good and correct is from Allah, and any mistakes are from myself. So I ask Allah to forgive me for those and ask you to seek that forgiveness for me from him as well. Wa jazakumullahu khairan wa barakallahu fikum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
JazakAllah khair, Imam Rafiq. Thank you very much for a beautiful speech and a very powerful reminder. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you tremendously.